It's not going to be long, not till 7 p.m. I should greet everyone first here and all the other places. I hope everyone is doing well. Today, I am actually speaking to live Bhutanese audience. So a lot of there may be a lot of Bhutanese sort of analogy or expressions or I don't know, idioms. You will have to bear this. I'm talking to those who are not here. Guru Rinpoche, or also known as Guru Pema Sambhava, has a special connection to Bhutan. There's actually physical places that you can visit, such as, of course, the Taktsang, and then Bhuntang Guji, and Myeongkhan Nering Sengkejong, all that. So, prayer to the Guru Rinpoche and also practicing Guru Rinpoche, doing Guru Rinpoche's puja, in other words, ceremonies such as chok, is very, very common actually in the Himalayas, especially in Bhutan. I would say a lot of course, especially in Bhutan, but many different parts of Himalayas, there is a very strong habit of chanting Vajraguru mantra, or otherwise, also what we call seven-line prayer, Sigdun Sondep. And then sometimes there's also long, you know, different kind of chapters of, seven chapters of Guru Rinpoche's prayers, otherwise known as Sondep Liu Dima. And then, of course, many, many Guru Rinpoche's sadhanas, so many. And then also in places like Bhutan, there's also celebration of Tsechu, sometimes even elaborating with a Tsechu mask dance depicting Guru Rinpoche's manifestations. But first I want to talk a little bit about who is Guru Rinpoche and also what is Soldep, Sondep. Now the Sondep, the Tibetan or the Dharma word calls, we use the word Soldep. It's a very difficult to translate these two words, Sol and Dep, especially when these two words are combined. I think the best translation or the most commonly known is prayer. So I guess this is why this gathering is under the title of How to Pray to Guru Rinpoche.